What I have here is a couple clips of the demo I got whenever they came out to my place to mow with the Ventrac 4500Z, the model that's before the unit I ended up purchasing. In the past, I had made purchases to take care of this property, which ended up not being successful for me to use. So the fact that I could get a demo on my property of what this machine could do on my hills was something I couldn't pass up on. So the dealer sent out a unit that was essentially the same as what I wanted to look at. You can tell by the ROPS being white, this is the 4500. It was the Z, which is what I wanted as well. But the newer model, the 4520Z, was available for order. So after this demo, I committed to purchasing, and then it was just a matter of waiting for delivery, which did take quite a while. This hillside, as he was going up and down, did cause the slope indicator to beep several times. The slope indicator by default beeps at 20 degrees. And you can see him going up and down on this hill multiple times. Now, this individual was much better at driving the Ventrac than I am so far. He actually was doing circles. Well, not really circles, but he was turning around and going left and right across the hillside at some points in one of the later clips. But you can see the height of these trees he's about to mow over are taller than the ROPS on the tractor. Right there. It looked really impressive to me that the machine was able to not bog down while it was going up and down these hills, mowing over the trees that were right here.
So the beeping is actually when you hit 20 degrees, so you know to start paying attention. He's coming up this little holler right here that is full of rocks and I can't get close to on the tractor. He's going up this thing like nobody's business. And he's just swivel left, swivel right, forward, backward. He's on a really steep slope right now. He says that the steepest he saw on this hillside was 24 degrees. Let's see if I can scooch over. Yeah, so he just turned around right up there, coming down the other side. This is where I can't mow with my tractor. And he's just going every which direction, left, right, forward, backward. Have to limb up some trees. And basically this thing has one speed, on. But basically, when you're mowing, you just go full speed. Kind of like our Mahindra, you just put it in full bore and away you go. No way I would have just done that with my tractor. Would not have happened. Dumb dog. Come here. Hey, come here. That was a thick branch. That was much bigger than 3/4 of an inch. Okay. I'm happy with this hillside. I do not believe we will have any issues. That was... Oh. Let's go. That was not what he mowed. As comparison, there's my thumb on the branch. He just does U-turns right on this right here. I'm happy with this part. On to the next victim.
Here we're coming back from my western hillside. I did not record going over because I was leading the way in the side-by-side with him following so he could see where I wanted to test the machine over here. This is the hillside and all of the woods that I'm trying to clean up. You can see on the left and right what I want to get the Ventrac into. This hill's pretty steep going down. I do have some areas like right here to the left that I've cleaned up to make it across the hillside to the other trail that goes down on the northern side of the hill. As you go down here, it's not only a slope downhill, but there are spots that slope to the right as you're going down. So you lean right going downhill. And there's also, I think it's right over the berm in front of him here, is a damage from a hog waller that used to be there. Grass has grown up, long gone. But the dip in the hole is still there. Yeah, you saw the Ventrac tire dip in, but the Ventrac didn't basically move at all. You'll see the side-by-side. Right there's the hog waller. And it causes the side-by-side more bouncing than it did the Ventrac. Down at the bottom here is the southern edge of our middle creek. It has an interesting turn that's always given me pause on the Mahindra. As you're going down, it gets a little steep, but then you need to go left and it gets steeper. Cross over the dry portion of the creek, and then you start climbing back up. This is the lost portion, TLC Homestead. This is the lost portion of our tiny lost creek. Creek runs year-round. There's fish on the northern side, but we must have caves because the water trickles out, and unless there's a flood, heavy rain, something. There's no rain right here where he's about, no water right here where he's about to cross. You see it dip down pretty steep, even giving the Ventrac a little bit of a pause as he considered how to approach that. So you can only imagine what I run into when a traditional tractor. I stopped here because right at the end of the video is the steep hill that has been a big challenge for me. You can watch the mower deck go up in the air as he starts to climb this right about there. And it's always given me a hard time. See, he slows down, raises the deck. He's trying to get a good angle to climb it. He gets up, but it is not an easy section of this trail.